Welcome back to Reading Bear. Today, we'll take a look at some new MIDA hole stories. And if you enjoyed my content, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and post some bear emojis in the comments. Let's go!
First one posted by user Lambo1983. AITA for buying a Lamborghini without consulting my wife in the middle of a pandemic? My wife, 30 female, and I, 38 male, both work. We have a shared account but each have our own personal bank accounts for our own personal fun spending that get 10% of our salaries. We both agreed to this and thought it was fair. When we came up with the 10%, I made significantly less money. My career and side hustles have both taken off in the last 10 years, so I'm making about 10 times what my wife makes when before it was more like 2 to 3 times. Anyways, one of the rules we have with our personal spending is that we don't have a say in how we spend that money as long as it doesn't affect our marriage. She typically spends her money on things for her like spa days, girls trips, random splurges, etc. I however have been saving most of my fun money because it's always been a dream of mine to own a Lamborghini. So I finally have saved up enough and bought a used Huracan from a guy in Cali. It's being delivered to me up here in Seattle. Here's the thing. When I told my wife, she was upset that I made such a big purchase without consulting her. But I mentioned that it was with my personal money and I'll maintain it and store it in a secure location with my fun money. She doesn't see it that way. She says that I'm tone deaf for buying such an extravagant car in the middle of a pandemic when people are struggling. I then reminded her that since the pandemic I've donated about $10,000 to local food relief and food banks, so what exactly is her point? I asked her what the difference was between me spending my money on one big purchase versus spending it all each month. She didn't have a good answer. Now she wants to set my max fund spending to be the same as her max spending, which is like 1% of my salary, which I don't think is fair. Anyways, AITA for not consulting my wife and also buying a Lamborghini in a pandemic? User comment, not the a-hole. It was your money from your discretionary spending account. You don't tell her how to spend hers, she shouldn't be complaining about how you spend yours. User comment, not the a-hole. If you stayed within your agreement, you are not in the wrong. You saved your money for this purchase and it's from your personal money. You are not putting the marriage in financial trouble by doing so. Only I see is you probably should have told her beforehand. Notice I said told, not discussed or asked permission. She probably is just in shock you saved that amount of money in your personal account. She doesn't get to tell you what to do with that money now because she has realized you are storing a chunk of change. Nope. User comment, not the a-hole, you two came to an agreement on your finances plain and simple, and I would hope you've had continuing discussions on how your salaries have changed since. And saving 10% of your salary for several years to make this purchase is perfectly responsible in contrast to blowing everything on the car and leaving nothing to cover debt and expenses. Lastly, how is not spending that money going to help anybody? Sure, you could have donated the same amount to a cause, but you work to save up for it, you're entitled to spend your money how you please. Next one posted by user, Princess Peach 112233. Titled, AITA for publicly scolding a random lady for shouting at me about my disability? So this happened a little over a year ago, but I was reminded on it today. Some backstory, I'm disabled and had to start using a cane in my mid-20s. I also often wear a neck brace to help manage pain and was wearing it when this situation occurred. Being visibly disabled while young, I have had ignorant or rude remarks made to me by strangers from time to time. I'm a pretty passive person, so I usually ignore it or nervously laugh it off. But this time I decided to say something. I was at a big chain dollar store buying some stuff and it was pretty busy. I was waiting in line, about 20 to 25 feet from the cashier, when she sees me and shouts at me, "Oh my God, what happened to you?" At least 15 people turned to stare at me when she yelled it. I was stunned and speechless for a few seconds and then just replied, "Nothing?" She comes back with, "Doesn't look like nothing." I responded that I was born with a genetic connective tissue disorder and now need these things. I felt so embarrassed that this lady drew attention to my disability and mobility aid like that. To shout at me and have all these people stare. I was regretting explaining my personal medical info with a store full of people just because she yelled at me asking about it. So by the time I got up to pay for my stuff, I had decided to say, you know, that made me really uncomfortable. You shouldn't shout at disabled people asking rude questions like that. I had expected her to at least say, ops, sorry. But instead she doubled down on wanting to know what was wrong with me exactly. I told her that was none of her business. She mumbled some remarks about how people are too sensitive these days and handed me my bag of stuff and kind of gave me a weird look as I left. Surprisingly, a couple people in my life did tell me I was the a-hole when I told them this story, because the lady was just curious. AITA. User comment, not the a-hole. I'm sorry you had to deal with that bratty toddler who never grew up. If it happens again, I hope you'll talk to the manager. There are times when it's absolutely appropriate to be that customer. User comment, not the a-hole, and I'm so sorry you had to experience that. Honestly, I would have spoken to a manager about such unprofessional behavior. You are never obliged to share your medical history with anyone who isn't actually giving you medical care. It was none of her business. It's one thing to ask, which I think is still quite rude, but this cashier definitely crossed a line when she kept pressing for details and then called you overly sensitive. You don't have to explain your disability to anyone unless you want to. People who demand you share your personal info are the real a-hole here. User comment, not the a-hole. This is why I dread leaving the house and using equipment on the days I need it. I have an uncommon medical condition that an observer can't see on my feet because of shoes. You can see it some on my hands. This makes walking extremely painful and can make it so I can't walk for days. My feet will literally bleed and split open. I'm also overweight because of this condition. I have had people mutter under their breath when I have had to use the scooters at the grocery store about me just needing to lose weight. Like they think I'm just lazy and don't have a medical condition. Now I have my own motorized wheelchair, scooter, and I'm still scared of being judged based on my physical size. People do not respect disabilities and how much of a sensitive topic that can be. Next one posted by user, Melly79. Titled, AITA for disrespecting an elder? Brief context, I am 20 female and live at home due to disability. Moved in with my dad and his girlfriend from my mum's in August 2020. My dad's girlfriend's mother, M, has not liked me since I moved her and met her for the first time. She's very traditional and doesn't like my more alternate style. Every time she sees me, she makes extremely rude comments about my clothes and body. I have always been quiet and like to keep the peace, so I never made a big deal out of it. I am very easily anxious and don't like causing problems. Today I was getting ready to go to my boyfriend and was wearing short shorts, warm day in the Sunshine State, and she was over at our house to hang out. I woke up with a lot of pain, so my temper is very short. She asked, is that really what you're wearing? Me, yeah, her, you're practically showing your whole backside? Do you want men to look at you when you're spoken for? Do you want to look like a streetwalker? I ignored this and finished tying my shoes and she snapped, you know it makes us look bad when you dress like a stripper, right? And I said, oh. Cry about it, I guess? And practically tucked tail and rushed out of the house because I made myself anxious. Now her, my dad, and his girlfriend have texted me to tell me I was in a hole for disrespecting her because she is my elder and I shouldn't speak that way because I live under their roof. She does not live with us. I'm still very anxious about going back and I feel like a major piece of crap, so I'm asking here AITA. User comment, not the a-hole. It may be their house, but she is disrespecting in a house you live at and she is a guest. If she doesn't want to see a night walker, the door is right there. User comment, not the a-hole. First, as an anxious, non-confrontational person myself, good for you for standing up for yourself. I'm really caught up on the fact that your dad didn't defend you against her incredibly rude remark. She owes you an apology. You do not owe respect, you are also an adult and respect should be mutually given. User comment, not the a-hole. She's the guest, you live there. Even if you are a street walker, it's none of her business. She's not even your legal guardian. does she say this crap to anyone on the street? Next one posted by user, iTax Mass Gifting. Titled, AITA for buying my boyfriend a second-hand set of knives when he got me a nice jewelry set? Boyfriend, 32, and I, 30, have been together 8 years. We are considered common law where we live and have no intention of getting married as we both agree it's a waste of money. His mother doesn't like me because I can't have children, and as my boyfriend is an only child, she blames me for depriving her of having grandchildren or being able to throw a massive wedding. My boyfriend is a chef. He had mentioned a few times how much he'd like his own set of fancy Japanese knives but couldn't afford to buy them for himself. The specific set he wanted was a couple thousand. By chance early last year I stumbled across a second-hand set on Facebook Marketplace that were the exact style he wanted and a complete set that was largely undamaged, a couple of handles needed replacing. I bought it and had it sent to a guy the first no through my boyfriend who repairs and sharpens chef knives and paid him to replace the handles, sharpen all the blades and carve my boyfriend's name into the handles in beautiful calligraphy. He also sourced a box to store them in. Afterwards you wouldn't have known they weren't brand new and they looked amazing. I gave him the set for Xmas and explained how I'd found them and his friend had repaired them for me and found a box to keep them in. He was stoked and loved them as a gift. He bought me a custom necklace earring set with my birthstone, opal, surrounded by small moissanite, imitation diamond, stones in white gold setting. They were stunning and I loved that he put the thought into them as a gift. The problem, his mother helped him order the stones so she knows how much he paid for them to be custom made and in comparison she thinks I've just given him a cheap set of second-hand steak knives and won't stop texting, calling me and is insisting that I'm a gold digger, etc. etc. In reality, we spent around the same but she won't listen and now I'm feeling guilty that I didn't buy a brand new set of knives even though it would have been double the price and I would have had to put it on my credit card or loan. Boyfriend insists I'm not the a-hole here but I'm starting to feel bad. Update, thanks for all your lovely comments. My mum died when I was quite young so I've always tried to be as nice as possible to my boyfriend's mum but I think I just have to face facts that a friendship between us isn't going to happen. Also my boyfriend has spoken to her on several occasions about her behavior and twice since Christmas but she insists that he's blinded by love and can't see me for what I really am. So it's good to get some independent judgment, thank you all so much. User comment, not the a-hole, your boyfriend might be in a hole, though. Why is mommy helping him order a gift for you and why is he not shutting her down if she's insulting you through text? Block her number if this persists, and tell him to straighten this out. If the knives are as you describe, second hand shouldn't matter all that much as they should be built to last quite a long time with proper care. User comment, not the a-hole. You got him what he wanted, he loved it and you saved money. Win, win, win. Who cares what she thinks? There's nothing wrong with second hand. User comment, not the a-hole. Don't let his mum get to you. Just focus on his answer of loving the gift and not the a-hole. Nothing wrong with second hand gifts in certain things. This being one of them. Next one posted by user, Muslim girl throwaway. Titled, AITA for telling a lady to go duck herself in a park. So, I, 16 female, am a Muslim. I was born and raised here, in America. I was hanging out with a few of my friends, and we were walking in the park, and I was wearing my hijab and a hoodie. My friends and I eventually ended up at a McDonald's and we ordered some food and went to sit in a park. This lady, she looked to be in her late 40s, kept staring at me, and she was with her son, who looked to be around 10 to 11. I was used to his, surprisingly so I ignored her, my friends noticed and sat in front of me, so she wouldn't stare. Eventually, I got so upset, I quickly put on the hood of my hoodie and took off my hijab, but made sure to cover my hair. She walked over. You. Yes. You're scaring my son. I was so confused, and looked back at her son who was just standing next to his mother. Sorry. All these bombings. These are all your fault. You people are disgusting, Muslims are all terrorists. Now, I know some still think of Muslims as terrorists, but I was horrified and confused. Sometimes people looked at me, but I never had someone accuse me or yell at me. My friends didn't know what to do, but one of them told her to go away. How can you stand to be next to her? the bombing, these are all their kind's fault. You should be ashamed of your religion. At this point I got mad. Really mad. It's disgusting to think you people are here. Terrorists. Get out of this country. She said a lot more. My dad always said this one line, so I said it. I am a Muslim, my religion is perfect, but I am not. If I make a mistake, you blame me, not my religion. I love this quote so much, but she kept going, and started cursing. Listen, if you think that being a Muslim is a personality trait, then I suggest you go duck yourself, because it is not. And it is disgusting to think that people like you are walking around saying this. Get the duck out of my face. She kept staring at me, but one of my friends got up and told her to duck off, and they all started yelling at the Karen until they left, and when she did I started crying. My friends told me it was okay and all, but I don't know. I felt like such an a-hole. Islam is the religion of peace, and here I was cursing out the old lady. I know she was wrong, but I can't help but feel I was too. So, AITA. User comment, not the a-hole. She started harassing you based on your religion, she's a bigot. And either she's brainwashed her son with this, or she's using him as a moral human shield. What you said is exactly right. Good job. User comment, not the a-hole at all. She's the racist, xenophobic adult, and you are the youth who was eating McDonald's with your friends. I'm so sorry you had to deal with that. She was so out of line. I hope her son grows up to realize how wrong his mum was, and chooses to love his neighbors. I'm proud to call you a fellow American. Your dad sounds like a great guy. User comment, not the a-hole. Op, your post was heartbreaking to read. I think given the circumstances, you were well within your rights to shut her down. She instigated the situation in the first place. I'm always saddened by ignorance and bigotry, but doubly so here, because you are so young, as is the woman's kid, who witnessed his mum's behavior. It's unsettling to know he's growing up thinking that's okay. I'm glad you have friends who care about you and stick up for you. Next one posted by user, AITA Daddy's Boy. Titled, AITA for buying toys for my husband but not my sister's child. I, 32 male, am married to my husband Tim, 25 male, and have been not only his husband but his non-sexual daddy. Not looking for judgment on that because I don't care what others think, but it's an important part of this. He had a nasty childhood and I have been helping him have what he was deprived of. Toys, comics, snacks, etc. I've dropped over 25k on him, I'm a lawyer and can afford it, in order for him to be happy. I love him, I take him to the park, zoo, not store, even Disney. We have a very healthy life and yes, he's seeing a psychiatrist. My sister, 26 female, and I are on bad terms. She lies and steals and is the princess of the family. She also has a son who is 5 years old. I don't talk to her unless I have to. For the most part, it's only online when I feel like being nice and messaging, as it's just her whining for money and how her husband left and her son needs a man in his life. I told her I don't want to be in her life, she's toxic and our parents refuse to see through her lies and keep letting her steal their things to sell. Well, she messaged today saying how her son has hardly any toys and she can't afford them because she works part-time. I told her no, I'm not giving her money, ask mum and dad. No clue how she found my husband's toy Instagram, but she brought up the fact that I pay for his childhood dream fantasy but not an actual child's, and I shot back with the fact that I actually love my husband. The love I had for her died the minute she called me a dumb faggot the first time she asked me for money and I said no. She called me in a hole and that her son hates me and I said so be it and blocked. AITA. User comment, not the a-hole. You owe her absolutely nothing, dude. Stick to your guns and keep her blocked. Advise your partner to do the same. User comment, not the a-hole. You and your husband need to block her. Don't engage. It's not worth her hurting you, or more likely she will target your husband because she knows that is what will hurt you. And I know you said not to comment on the relationship, but your husband is lucky to have a daddy that cares for him and nurtures that part of him. Keep looking after each other. User comment, not the a-hole. Your money is for your family. However, I had a total deja vu moment and wonder if in 20 years there will be a post from your nephew complaining about what a horrible childhood he had. I hope your parents have enough money to purchase him something nice. Last one posted by user, 9JKEO. Titled, AITA for deleting pictures of an overweight cosplayer. Back when it was safe to gather, my friend and I went to an event for anime lovers. There were many cosplayers there and most of them would let others take pictures of them when asked. We approached many cosplayers and taken pictures of them. During the event, we saw two women together cosplaying as elves, one blue, overweight, and the other purple, slim. I wanted to take pictures of the purple elf but figured that the blue elf may feel offended if I did not ask her, so I asked both for permission and they let me take pictures of them. After the event, me and friend sat somewhere and shared the pictures we took. After browsing my gallery, my friend asked me where were the pictures of the blue elf and I told her I deleted them, I only wanted the purple elf to begin with. She then gave me a look of disgust and called me a hole for deleting the pictures as she thinks that overweight cosplayers deserve respect. I find no problem in that because the pictures were my own to keep and the blue elf was not the only one I deleted. It was not as if the cosplayer herself would have known anyway and none of my friend's business what I choose to keep. We argued for a while and eventually just forget about it. So now I am posting this and asking AITA for deleting? User comment, you're the a-hole, but not for anything to do with the photos. You know deep down that how you feel towards the overweight elf is different than how you feel the slim elf. You need to figure out why that is and stop thinking that overweight people are less deserving of respect. User comment, you need to stop demanding respect in the form of admiration from people, because nobody is entitled to that from anyone. Op was highly respectful in the sense of politeness. Hell, Op would have still been fine if she just asked the slim cosplayer for photos in the first place. Not the a-hole. User comment, not the a-hole, no one can tell you what type of cosplays you should like and who cares if it's your own personal album of photos, delete it if you don't like it, simple. What would make you truly an obvious fatphobic is by not including the fat cosplayer when you ask for a photo, at least when you delete it in private no one gets hurt. Thanks for listening.